Hello and welcome to ATP Report. I'm Barry Nussbaum. Before I get to our very special guest with us tonight, I want to remind all our viewers in ATP land to please take out your cell phone and text the message TRUTH, T-R-U-T-H, and send it to the number 88202, push send. You'll be signed up. You'll get this and all of our shows on the cell phone in the palm of your hand, absolutely free. Let's bring on our special guest. It's Trevor Loudon. He's the author of both the book and the movie, The Enemies Within, and he's famous around the world as a political commentator. Welcome, Trevor.
Hi, how are you, Barry? Thanks for having me on.
Oh, it's such a pleasure to have you back. Really, it's an honor. So let's kick it off with what the heck is going on at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. President Biden is appointing people that, for the best of my interpretation, don't seem to like America or American foreign policy very much, and seem to be making noises that, well, they're going to change the way America sees the world and obviously the way the world sees America. It's almost like there's a socialist revolution on Pennsylvania Avenue. What do you think?
Absolutely. We are in a communist revolution. This is just as real as Cuba or Venezuela or Czechoslovakia or Poland back in the 1940s. If Fidel Castro was in the White House right now, he'd be behaving exactly as Joe Biden is. And Americans need to wake up to this. This is not trying to make America like France or Germany. This is trying to make America like Venezuela or Cuba. That's what we're looking at here.
How bad is it? There's a dozen appointments that, for the life of me, when we talk about it at ATP, Trevor, I don't understand why he's picking these people.
Well, it only makes sense if you're a revolutionary. Look, a couple of examples on the domestic front. You know, Deb Haaland, who is now the Secretary of the Interior, she has control over 20% of America's land mass and 20% of this country's natural mining resources and energy resources. The woman is a full-on Marxist. She was engineered into that position by Judith LeBlanc of the Communist Party USA. The Communist Party USA is a pro-Chinese, pro-Beijing organization. You've got basically an agent of China now running 20% of America. You know, Pete Buttigieg, you know, Secretary of Transportation, the man who wants to tax Americans for every mile they drive. You know, he has long-time ties to Democratic Socialists of America. He is very actively involved with those radical groups when he was mayor of South Bend, Indiana. And his father, Joseph Buttigieg, was one of the leading Marxist scholars on the planet. He was a world authority on Antonio Gramsci, the Italian communist theoretician who invented basically what we would now call a Bernie Sanders, the Democratic Socialist movement. Javier Becerra, Health and Human Services, very deep Marxist, has been involved with the Communist Party and other radical groups in California for decades. So on every front, not just foreign policy, on every front, Biden is appointing Marxists.
Okay, well, that's really bad news. Now let's talk let's talk about maybe some good news, maybe. So there's audits going on in a number of states that have Republican either legislators or senior officials, like in the governor's office and the attorney general's office. And I'm talking specifically about Nevada, Arizona, Georgia, and possibly Pennsylvania, where irregularities are being leaked out constantly. But here's a problem, and I don't know the answer to this, and I'm interested in your best guess, Trevor. What happens constitutionally or practically if Arizona finds thousands of ballots that get decertified? Is the Electoral College overturned?
Look, I don't believe it will be. I wish it would be. You know, when Lance Armstrong won the Tour de France and was found to have cheated, they stripped his titles, did they not, several years later. But I can't see that happening here. You know, possession is 9 points of the law. The Democrats are not going to give up what they have, and the Supreme Court is not going to call in their favor. The Supreme Court is going to wash their hands of it. What it will do, and I think this is the most valuable thing that's happening right now, it will completely destroy any legitimacy the Biden administration has in front of the whole world. The Biden administration will be exposed as corrupt, as cheating, and illegitimate. So that will embolden the red states to basically ignore anything that comes out of Washington. They will just, you know, and this is what I'm advocating. The red states have to band together, stand on the 10th Amendment, and defy any unconstitutional legislation or directives coming out of Washington. A little bit like California used to defy everything that Trump told them to do on immigration issues, and nobody seemed to have a problem with that.
Well, yeah, but the problem that I don't see changing, at least not in my next lifetime, or this lifetime for that matter, is the press is cheerleading everything on the left, and regular people that are just trying to find out what the heck's going on are having trouble getting news. And I don't mean from the newspapers and television, even from the internet, which is now supplying most of the news to most of the country, is so heavily censored or stepped on. How are people going to find out what's going on?
Well, that is one of their biggest problems. You see, Ron DeSantis, God bless him, governor of Florida, signed a law just a couple of days ago, heavily penalizing big tech for censoring opinion. Now, that is not going to just go through in Florida. That's going to spread right through the red states. And this is perfectly timed for the information flow we're going to need. We're either going to see big tech find out of existence and become little tech very shortly, or they're going to have to reverse their repressive policies. We're coming to a real showdown in America. We've got a polarization. We've got a communist government, straight out communist government in Washington, D.C. And we've got 30 red states who are waking up to their power and seeing and are starting to band together to defy the federal government, stand on the 10th Amendment, which guarantees a Republican form of government, a representative form of government, and reiterates the principle that the federal government serves at the pleasure of the states, not the other way around. So this is a fascinating battle of wills we're seeing here. And you got the communists who want to take us down, and you got people waking up who want to save the country. Who's going to win? That's the big issue that we're talking about here.
Well, I'll throw a wild one at you. In the red states that have made the largest amount of noise from the general population, hey, we got cheated, is where Trump has announced he's going to have a speaking tour, starting off apparently even with Bill O'Reilly going on the road with him. And now there's this, I don't know if you want to call it a rumor, but discussion being thrown around that what Trump ought to do is run for a House seat in 2022. And if the Republicans take back the House of Representatives, he gets elected Speaker of the House, which puts him third in line to the presidency. What do you think about that?
Well, I think it's a very interesting possibility. But until we've gotten rid of Mitch McConnell and Kevin McCarthy, I don't quite see it happening. I think they would be tearing their hair out at that prospect. You know, Trump lost because of China, because of the Democrats and traitors within his own party. And the big priority right now is to remove those traitors. So such a scenario would be even possible.
Well, let's talk about your 10th Amendment idea. It's a fascinating constitutional issue you're raising. And I, as someone who knows the Constitution, I love the discussion point. So let's be more specific. Governor Abbott in Texas just announced, if you break into his state, i.e., you're a felon illegally violating federal and Texas state law, and you illegally cross the border into Texas, he's not going to call the Border Patrol. He's not going to call federal law enforcement. he's going to have the troopers on the border arrest you for violating Texas state law, which he has the power to do. But get this, Trevor, Washington has already come out and said, you can't do that. The enforcement of immigration law is federal only and has been delegated to the federal government, and it can't revert to the states. You've got a constitutional issue on your hands here. Who's going to win that one?
We sure have. Well, this is not immigration. This is invasion. This is criminal behavior. The government has the right to regulate who legally immigrates. States have a right to defend their borders against felons. So I think that Texas has got a very, very good case here. But even if the Supreme Court rules against them, I think this is a time to defy the Supreme Court. What's the federal government going to do? You know, this is what I'm saying. You got 30 states still controlled by Republican legislatures. You've got hundreds of red counties and blue states. That's 80% of America. All of them have an interest in who is streaming across the border. And this power block, this nation within a nation, stretches from Alaska in the Arctic Circle through North Dakota, South Dakota, Idaho, right to the middle of the country, down to the Gulf of Mexico and the Florida Keys. This is 80% of America we're talking here. Do you think the federal government is going to stand against that if these states band together and say, we will guarantee our own states a Republican form of government if the federal government refuses to do so? And I think this is going to be a great showdown here. And I tell you who's going to win it. If the states band together, they will beat back the federal government because the people will be on their side. The vast bulk of Americans are very disconcerted about the lax border policies right now. That's probably the number one issue for millions and millions of people. And if Texas takes a stand, if Arizona takes a stand, the red counties of New Mexico, and even if California take a stand, I know who's going to win that battle.
Well, I'll give you some good news, and that's the following. When Biden says, we're not arresting people, we're not going to detain them, we're going to release them without charges being filed, we're going to ask them to come back to court, and wink, wink, we know they never will, right? He's violating federal law because the laws are on the books passed by Congress, who has exclusive control over legislation on immigration. Biden is unilaterally deciding not to enforce the law, Trevor. So yeah. It would seem to me there might be a court case where the courts can say the president can't change the law without the Congress.
Well, that's exactly right. There's a very strong case here for the states. But I just want to add another little kicker here that nobody's talking about. This is not constitutional. See, Mexico now has a Marxist president, AMLO, Obrador, former member of the Mexican Communist Party, active in the Sao Paulo Forum, which was set up by Lula of Brazil and Fidel Castro to spread socialism right through Latin America. The man is a Marxist. Now, what I'm hearing from people in his Morena party is that he has just won the midterms. He's going to go full on Venezuela in Mexico. He is going to go full on socialist. Well, when Venezuela, which was once the richest country in Latin America, went socialist, they lost 20% of their population just getting out of the country. Well, 20% of 30 million is about 6 million. Mexico's got 130 million people. Where are 20% of them going to go if they go full on Venezuela and Mexico? That's what we're looking at here, people. We're looking at 1 million a year coming across right now. This is going to be 4, 5, 6, 7 million in a couple of years if this isn't stopped.
Well, you just scripted your next movie, and this is a horror movie, Trevor. It's not politics. It's like the apocalypse has come, and it's real. Thanks for coming on today. Tell us how we can find out about what you're doing and where we can follow you.
Look, I'm doing a movie, Enemies Within the Church, about the Marxist infiltration of the churches. go to enemieswithinthechurch.com. You can see trailers there, etc. Or go to my daily blog, trevorlowden.com. You can see my movies there, my books there. You can order signed copies of my books. But don't Google trevorlowden.com, because Google seems to have lost that address. You'll have to put it in the search bar at the top of the page. I'm sure you'll understand what I'm talking about, Barry. There's a little bit of censorship going on, you may have noticed.
Just a little. And yes, we've noticed at American Truth Project. Thanks for coming on today. We sure appreciate your insight. And for everybody out there in ATP land, remember to subscribe. You know how. Text 88202 and put the message truth, push send. We'll sign you right up for free. Thanks for coming on today with us at ATP Report. I'm Barry Nussbaum.